My name is Sergei Jargin, or in English, Sergei Jargin. I am from the People's Friendship University of Moscow, Russia. I came here with two presentations. I will tell about only one, which probably is more important, summarizing our research, many years research, about medical consequences of the Chernobyl accident. And to put it briefly, our opinion is that the medical consequences of the accident were largely exaggerated. There was a lot of interest to inflate the topic. There are several publications which overtly overestimate the consequences. And today the opinion is that the only proven oncological consequence of the radiation exposure after the accident is the thyroid cancer in children and adolescents, in those exposed in the at an early age. According to our opinion and data we dispose of, this is largely an exaggeration, and it is completely probable that the whole increase of the incidence was caused by not by radiation, but by other factors. First of all, which is important, that the pre-accident incidence of thyroid cancer in the areas where the contamination occurred was considerably lower than in all developed countries. It was for the north of Ukraine 0.1 cases per million per year. For example, in the most West European countries and North America, it is around 1.5, incomparably low. In Belarus, it was 0.3. So it means that in the population of the contaminated areas, the pediatric thyroid cancer was underdiagnosed. Or in other words, there was a pool of undiagnosed neglected cancers in the population. And about 3-4 years after the accident started massive screening, which found all these cancers. Screening was performed mainly among children. Children are easily available for screening in schools and kindergartens. Screening teams performed ultrasound examination, found nodules. Nodules are relatively frequent there because it is the iodine deficiency area. And it is acknowledged in the literature that there was also a lot of overdiagnosis. There was an atmosphere of cancerophobia and radiophobia and many questionable cases were interpreted and classified as cancer. And as it can be seen in the tables in our presentation, 3, 4, 5 years after the accident, about a half of the cases were T4, fourth stage, the latest stage. And this stage, of course, needs time to be grown up to this stage. It means that old neglected tumors were misclassified as aggressive radiogenic cancer. And apart from this mechanism, it must be stressed that it was a considerable percentage of false positivity. So there was an insufficient experience with pediatric tumors. It was the atmosphere of cancerophobia, and certainly some percentage of cases was overdiagnosed. There was another mechanism also known, that population knew that in the contaminated areas is organized high quality medical care of thyroid diseases, and some patients were brought from other non-exposed areas, and more or less biased information given that the child was somewhere near during the accident. So in other words, many persons were registered as Chernobyl victims without being exposed. All this augmented the incidence figures. And which is also important to point out, there was considerable conflict of interest. First, in the beginning, it was the topic was inflated because there was international help, international cooperation, financing. So some researchers and some decision makers, some managers were interested in inflating the topic to concentrate attention to it. And later it also has become evident that some larger interests, maybe political interests, are also in play because the Chernobyl topic was misused to strangle the nuclear energy. The topic was exaggerated, and it is known that many, many projects of nuclear power stations were stopped or delayed due to the Chernobyl impact. It is known, for example, that in Germany, as far as we know, it is constantly prevailing the opinion that all nuclear stations must be closed. And today it has become evident that nuclear energy is the safe and clean energy if everything is done properly. And it is probably the single possibility for the mankind to meet all energy needs. So that's why we think that this presentation is of importance to make it clear today that the consequences of this accident were exaggerated and misused for above-named purposes.